advert.
I don't know what it is. Wait, the next 2 minutes as the umpire holds it aloft. Hovey and Banjanin to go at it again. Banjanin actually jumped at Hovey as the ball comes out of there, trying to crash his way through a Super Joe. Dishes off the handball to Jacko Davis. Ball enters into St. Joey. No, it doesn't. The wind held that up. Palioris picks it up. Can he get on his bike? Wade, he just ignores his tackle. Kelleher traps the footy. Goes over the boundary line. We'll have a throw in. 25-30 around from St. Joey's goal. A better start, boys.
I don't mind this tactic going up against the breeze with that smaller forward line, boys. So when the ball hits the ground, they've got a better chance of locking it in.
Ball comes out the back of the pack. Davis, can he pick it up? So too, going to ground was Palioris. Umpire circling. Nothing doing. We'll have a ball up. Same spot, though.
It was Trigger Boy, too.
And we had a word at halftime.
Oh, I'd love to have been in their room at halftime.
I want to know what he wrote down.
Who got a bigger back, Joey's or the umpires?
He thought up Banjanin was deft with his touch, but went to no advantage. Super Joe just tries to scrag his way out of there, wrapped up by Hall.
Oh, look. No.
Nothing doing for holding the footy. And we'll do it all again, just another metre around from where we did the last one. So right in the forward 50, probably just only 10 metres around from goal. Williams went third up, couldn't win it. Wade was taken quickly in a tackle. Falls to Cole, was just pushed off by Palioris, who showed some good strength. He's at ground level, trying to win possession of the footy. And the ball did trickle out before Reece Holcren could run to an open goal. And we'll throw it in, Milky, 15.
Lifted their intensity, I'll give them that for the first minute and a half, St. Joseph's. Got to give them that.
It was certainly flat the last two quarters starting off, so it's a good sign.
Spinning ball. Up it goes. Holcren knocks it down into the path of Jimmy Allen. He can't trap it. Tries to go back through. That's Kelleher, but the ball cleared by Sherman. Lovick, can he trap it? No, he can't. Dobson dishes off the handball. Over to Garner. Garner's kick out wide. Measures. Ooh. Takes it. What was he yell for? Measures. I was trying to what the crowd were yelling for. I'm looking what's going wrong.
Push in the back, I think.
Yeah. Measures. Spears it wide. Finds Reese. Needs to lift.
Yeah, this is it. This movement here.
Brenton Reese goes in the centre. Oh, you picked it. He's gone straight across. He's killing. He's got to hang on it. He's got no one running into the arc. Dishes it off to Gillies. And tapped it clear. The Joey's boys crashed into one another. Gillies gives it across to Travellini. Travellini goals. Bang!
Jeepers.
Whoa.
Well, curse it. That mistake simply doesn't happen when St. Joey's are playing footy and they got confidence. That's a complete lack of confidence in the way they're playing.
Reece has kicked that ball backwards.
Yep.
From the wing to the centre.
He missed the target by 10 metres there.
In the corridor.
Carson getting attended to. Sorry, Kirsch.
No, you're right, mate.
I think that was brilliantly done by Killen on the offence, though. He could have looked up and just blazed away, but Carson was running back to cover it. He held his kick. It was not quite perfect for Gillies, but it did enough to allow Gillies in and set up the goal as Carson's still in the hands of trainers.
They're going to be one short here if Carson doesn't get up. They wouldn't want to send a clearance.
Blood to out of scoreboard, 10-7-67. St. Joey's 5-3-33.
As a coach, I'd be saying get off or...
They've
get
just
up.
Thrown Maloney behind the ball as well, Milky.
Came in.
Ball comes back. Jacko Davis overruns it. Super Joe gets it. Bouncing ball. Comes back to Tenace. Can he pick it up? Yes, he can. Dishes off the handball to Garner. Garner across to Sherman. Sherman across to Cole. Heavy traffic in there. Tudor tries to get it. Davis overruns it. Bottom of the pack. Umpire circling. He's got one for a trip. Trip to Tudor.
One of those
it was actually Cole on the other way around. Yeah, so did I.
Oh, Trigger Boy.
So Carson coming off here, boys. Tudor kicks a bit of an up and under. Banjanin's right at the base of it. Williams tries to take the mark. He can't make Wade. He gets a footy, then heaves it out. Picked off by Maloney. Maloney has a bounce. Goes towards... No, he doesn't go towards goal. He, in fact, kicks it out in the full.
Sums up the day, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Shows Dale. Some good pace.
Dale Carson, though.
Doesn't look good.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
Heavily dazed.
Shoulder or?
I reckon it was a head clash.
Yeah, I reckon he's just seeing a few
look
stars.
Look who they find out the outer side.
How does that happen?
In a lot of space on the outer side. He's just allowed to handball nonchalantly over the top to Manu, just weaves through as if no one was in front of him. Finds Callum Wade.
Look at this.
Running to about 60 out. Handball over the top to Jones. He ambles inside 50. The resulting kick was not good. Just grubbers along the boundary line. Capra's happy to see it over. So it was promising attack just brought undone.
They're
by
almost going in second
Scalera.
Gear there, Mary. So it was the training run style stuff.
Tenace was sort of just waiting, saying, come on, one of you just come past me and I'll give it to you.
So they'll be thrown back in. We've played 5 minutes on the Blood Toyota scoreboard. St Mary's 10-7-67, St Joey's 5-3-33, and on the ropes. Comes in, darkening skies too here at West Oval.
Ball South Toronto, we're going home.
Ben Shannon, Jones, has a rip it clear of his hands. Lovick just finds a way
to
extract the footy.
Needs
looks
a target.
For McCullough's hands were nice.
Got him out, didn't he? Yep.
He's on this broadcast side.
Yep.
He's at half back. You spot on, Kirsch. It's the next kick they've had trouble with. Oh. It's forced to go short. Yeah. There it is. It was a 10-metre pass that he can't make. And Joe's not happy with the movement.
And Riley Hall giving it to him too. Giving it to him.
So the ball will be brought back. Just defensive side of centre wing, near side.
You know, it's about 8 metres away where he was.
I smell chips.
Oh, look at that sauce. Spinning ball. Oh, lovely.
Spinning ball comes back in. Hovey wins it. Knocks it clear. Oh, Haynes just gets thrown out of there. At the bottom of the pack is Williams. Can he get it clear? Umpire circling says, no, give it to me.
I'm surprised Trigger Boy umpire here didn't call it from 80.
Yep. Just saw the...
He was about to.
Joey's trying to put
a thumbs
up. Thumbs
up there. I don't know who that was directed to.
Super Joe crashes through. Tumbling ball. Holtgren is the target. And oh, Ben Jennon. Who's he into over here?
Oh, it's on. Right. Trigger Boy's got it.
Trigger Boy's got it.
It's on him. Yeah, I'll watch it, Milky.
Ball has gone forward.
Bounds.
Still trying to see who that player is. It's now on top of Ben Jennon.
They're really going at it too.
Yep. Why has he blew his whistle?
Not sure. It was Jacko Davis. The ball, it's a free kick to Joey's. Oh, Ben Jennon.
Oh, umpire, what are you doing?
He's getting a card out here.
Yeah. Ben Jennon. Banjo picking on the little blokes.
I think
they've coughed it up, Joey's. All that's going on.
What's happening?
Ball comes
I'm
back.
I'm confused. Mo Boy's gone off.
Free kick.
He's been sent off, Ben Jennon.
Over on the other side of the ground. The ball's still in play. Joey's had a chance to go forward, and they've coughed it up. It's gone back. Now it's in dispute.
Yep.
Comes back out. Jimmy Allen back to Williams. Tries to does defend off, then goes to ground.
Oh, turns but over.
Is that McMahon who picks it up?
Yeah.
Goes towards Jones. He's got Lovick to beat. Lovick goes to ground, then Falcons it over the boundary line. Have a throw in. Out of side.
Has cards been shown?
Yeah, Ben Jennon's been sent off. Yellow carded.
Ben Jennon was off.
Trigger Boy again.
Don't they have to stop play to give out a yellow card?
No,
I don't know. I thought that was
who knows.
The play was stopped when he got sent off. It was a shot on goal. So he comes in. At the front of the pack. Hovey wins it down.
Oh, wow.
Just burst clear. Takes a bounce. Caresses it over the top to Jones. He should go back and take the numbers.
Tudor!
Why wouldn't you have a shot from there? You're 35-40 out.
Exactly right, Kirsch.
Look at
Tudor! Across, and then Tudor turns it over. Wow. Well, incredible scenes. This game of footy is just baffling the mind at the moment. Snowden, 70 out, chips in.
Oh, back to Tudor! Kick
to
kick!
It's a bit of kick to kick. And out.
It is Tudor baffling the great minds at the minute.
So this game descending into a visual farce.
I just missed Burpeth.
The Tudor kick was over the head of Erfurth, but he's a left footer, so right side for him.
Goes
looking for McCullough, who has to get rid of Lang. Morrison at the fall of the ball. Hands were pretty good, but they missed the target. It was Haynes he was looking for. Wade was just going to be dumped by Ferguson. The ball comes clear. Lang tries to pick it up. Fazio's hands were pretty good. Verfer chopped it off. Morrison. Now Callagher wants his right foot. He's pressured into a mistake. Fazio at ground level. Plenty of bodies around this one. And they want the line in the end. The ball just finds its own way over the boundary line. Sinewing this broadcast side, we've played 8.5 minutes. So I'll let you finish that, Matt.
It's all good. I'm ready to go. Just shove one in and bot it quickly as the ball comes in. Hovey has front spot. Snowden puts him
too strong, Garner.
Garner just too strong. Then gets around, measures, then steadies.
Too far.
Trigger but boy. He kicked the damn goal.
Would have had himself a... voucher from the Elite Training Centre there, Jared Garner.
He would have.
Missed out.
I think he just got the speed wobbles a bit.
Just a little bit, didn't he, at the end?
Just straightened up.
Yep.
Certainly not taking advantage of the 17 men at the moment, are they? All the players being with St Mary's.
Can't they replace them now?
Oh, can they?
Yeah, I think so, can't they? Buzz, didn't you tell me that a couple of weeks ago? As Lovick goes, finds Keller.
Did he say no? You said yes.
I think they can replace them now. Oh, he goes out to Morrison, but chipped off by Maloney! By McMahon. McMahon goes to Jones. Takes the mark in the pocket.
He won't pass this time.
Yep. That's a special comment.
He's been really good, Hayden McMahon.
Yeah, so is this boy too.
Jones. Yeah, no, but just the pace that he's given Hayden McMahon.
Yeah, both of the McMahon brothers are just reading the play well, aren't they?
And backing themselves with pace, aren't they?
Pure footballers.
Jones, he's got 3-1 for the afternoon. He's got 3-2. for the afternoon.
He half celebrated. He has celebrated.
He hit his chest, the umpire.
He did.
Tool. Oh, sorry. Four goals, one he has on the Blood Toyota scoreboard. That takes St Mary's. I reckon this game's over, boys.
I reckon it's just about done.
11-7-73, St Mary's. They lead St Joseph's 5-3-33. 40 points margin at the 10-minute mark of the third quarter.
You said it, Kurt. They just couldn't make use of the extra
man. Can't. I mean, how many times do they turn the ball over in the middle of the corridor? Every time. They're still trying to pull the trigger in the corridor.
You could have five extra men, but the way they're kicking, they'd still be losing.
Disgusting.
Yeah. Back in the middle. 10.5 minutes played. Cheetah jumped early, but Snowden just puts the fist through it and nearly gets it inside 52. Morrison finds McCullough, just dumps a left foot high up and under footy. Ball still in the middle of the ground. Mark wasn't quite hauled in. Ball at ground level. Williams tries to burst clear and does all right. Just gets a toe to it. The ball trickles inside 50. Kelleher's first to it. Just wheels around. Found some space. And on the left foot, Riley Hall did brilliantly well against Holcroft. Oh! To ground. Lang just scrubbers a kick. Codanger. He's nearly out in the full.
Did you see that? Codanger?
Codanger behind play,
missed it.
Gave him one running pass.
Yep.
Kick was out in the full from Lang anyway, so it'll be taken by Dreyer. He's just outside the paint of 50, near side, front of the pavilion, but he has a little one over the top.
It's a dead pocket.
Pocket of death. Tim Arnell, wasn't it?
Finds Tim Arnell, spot on Milky. Still the same angle, though, very tight. It's not a bad.
You have to run right out of here.
A right footer, but that breeze.
We saw what Garner did in the same spot.
That breeze is going from left to right, so it'll be a tough kick for Arnell.
I'd say impossible.
Yep. Oh, you would kick it.
I'd kick it.
You know what you do? You'd run out to your right and kick it hard at the left post.
Correct.
Timmy Arnell.
He's running straight.
Out right in front of that old pavilion.
Oh, he's done a reasonable job of it. No.
Good job, but reasonable job. Faded pretty late with that breeze through for a behind.
Which is where we thought.
1-1 for the afternoon. 12 minutes played.
They've already brought it back in. Milky. He's got another should go here, Arnell. Goes with the old bouncing ball along the ground. The dribble kick that Jason Dunstall says, why would you waste your time?
Yeah, very low percentage, that one.
Very, very low. And it's already out on the centre wing. Tenace brought it out there. Puts it out in front of Henderson. Bouncing ball. He's got two to beat. Lovick's there. Also Verfith, but the boundary line beat both of them, and we'll have a throw-in out of side. Chips aren't bad, Buzz. Enjoy them while you can.
Get cold quick.
They do get cold quick. That's why I tried to shove a few in before while I could. Ball comes in. Snowden. Rucks have had the better of it today for St Mary's. As Travellini, he gets it over the boundary line. No, I thought it might have just come off the boot and gone over on the full, because I'm only 100 metres away, so I'm a good judge of that. Throw-in out of side.
Yep, ball on centre wing. Just quickly around the grounds, Milky, while we have a little break. BFL, Motawari still in the front. 8-3-51 to Queenscliff, 5-9-39. Ball back in play here at West Oval, though. Ball trickles clear. There's a whistle. There's a man down for St Mary's. Retaliation doesn't really come, so not sure what it was for. He's rolling around in pain, though. Can't quite catch who it is.
He's going to wear out the pee in his whistle. Out this there.
Fazio.
It is Fazio, you're right, Milky. Yep. So Travellini will take the free kick anyway. Not sure how that works. Explain that one to me. He's on centre wing, though.
I thought if you can't take your kick, you've got to get off the ground.
Yep, that's what I thought too. Ball to the back. It's a good mark running back of the flight, Cam Tudor.
Misses
measures, and Bond chips in and takes the mark.
No good clapping your hands and saying, crap, Cam Tudor, because it was crap.
Skill errors have truncated that afternoon, Kirsch.
Yep.
Truncated.
I'm not sure what that means, but if that means cost him.
Doug Bond, 14 goals this year.
Where should he kick this one, Milky?
It's a bit like getting a woody. Straight through the guts is probably the best way.
Doug Bond. And this one is nearly as good as done. The reigning premier are on the ropes. St Mary's have kicked their 12th goal for the afternoon. 12-7-79. On the Blood Toyota scoreboard, St Joey's 5-5-35.
Game over, I reckon.
Oh, well,
haven't looked. They've got to kick 8 goals to win the game. They've only kicked 5 so
at
far
least,
for the game.
They have to kick more than 8.
But they don't look like kicking the next. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does make a lot of sense.
They need to kick.
Wouldn't mind that heater right now.
The turnovers has killed St Joey's all day as the ball comes back.
Butchered the ball. Truncated or something.
Truncated it.
Whatever that word
truncated
is.
Truncated the ball. Truncated the lead. Is that like elephantitis?
I'm not sure what it is.
Back in the middle, up they go. Buzz has a laugh while his mic's turned off as the ball comes through. Oh, Kershaw goes the barrel into the breeze, if you don't mind. Hulkgren to the front. Crummers required. Oh, Lang just backs back out of the pack, dishes it off. Tenace picks it up. Got Jacko Davis to get around. Lays the tackle. Can't quite get there. McMahon, he's dispossessed. Kelleher needs to find a target. Goes very wide. McMahon chips in. Clears it. Melody, I think that is at ground level. Can't hang on. And then, again, it's picked off by Cole, who's been really good. Back to McMahon. That's a Hayden variety. Puts it in front of Jones. Capra under pressure. Ball goes over the boundary line. Yeah, gee whiz, they get it from one ground, one end of the ground to the other really
very
quick,
easy
don't they?
Exits, isn't it?
Yeah. Between the arcs, their ball movement's very quick.
And they're either getting that 50-50 stoppage or they're winning the ball on those exits a lot of the time.
It's very easy to exit.
Back.
Barnsley, it's very easy to exit without pressure, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, definitely. That's why Joey's keep turning over, because they don't have the options.
Exactly
the Smurfs
right.
Can just waltz out.
Yep.
Brought back in, 52 out from St Mary's goal. Capra from the stoppage, left foot ball, just more in hope than anything else. Tenace nearly chopped it off, couldn't quite. Kelleher has been pretty lively this quarter, actually. By hand is good to McCoola. Oh, goes very short to Davis, who had to stretch it centre half forward, but he did. He's got the slight overlap. There was a 2-on-1 contest, but it was well halved. Tenace by hand did pretty well. Callum Wade wrapped up, probably a throw.
He threw it.
And it was, so Super Joe, the man who laid the tackle.
And wants 50. And wants 50, Super Joe.
Not sure why he's appealing to 50.
No, he wants a 50.
Just while we're waiting, Super Joe got the break there and looked up, and there were three St Mary's players in the forward 50. No St Joseph's.
No, McCoola just goes into the pocket, low percentage kick, just falls short of any real target. Cole has been very good, finds McMahon, goes inboard by hand, they are out, finds Nick Connors. Just drives it inside 50. It's Capra and Jones. Jones went early to try to get the jump on Capra. Lovick below his knees. Has to be clean. He was. Found his old mate Capra. He's,
old mate.
He's good. By left foot. Was nice. Out wide. Measures. They've got overlap again, Joe. He's got to use it. Maloney at half forward. Kicks inside 50. That's nice. And he finds Palliuris straight in front, 40 out.
Boys, I know we mentioned then that they need a lot more overlap, and they got that overlap then, but their overlap was still nearly out of reach.
Yep.
They get the ball, and it's just they have to get that momentum again because the ball was not to perfection. So
the fingertip one to Jacko Davis. All of a sudden, it goes back the other way in an awful hurry.
Yep. It's just cleanliness. They're just not clean at all.
Palliuris straight in front, hard at the left post
left.
He needs.
Got to
left,
go left.
Post, even outside the left.
Yes, he has.
Oh, he has, and it's just feeds itself back straight through the guts. And to say that's a...
Need seven more of them.
Very important goal for St Joey's. Thinking it's way too late. At the 17.5-minute mark of this third quarter, on the Blood Toyota scoreboard, it's St Joseph's 6-5-41. They trail St Mary's 12-7-79. They need to double their score now if St Mary didn't score again.
Yep. Yeah, around the ground. Essendon up by 43 points over Carlton.
Wowee.
Jeez.
They are no good, Carlton. They cost me 9 winners last week.
Back in the middle.
Are they still below Brisbane on percentage?
Connors. His hands were good. Travellini was taken without it. No free kick doing. Firth haven't called his name much today. He's beaten to it by Travellini, who tries to paddle to his own advantage. Couldn't Tudor with some sort of volleyball spike out of trouble.
What it was.
Cole shows a bit of toe, Harry Cole. Goes in board by hand. Couldn't quite pick it up. Ball falls clear.
Oof.
And the kick on goal.
Dobson.
Oh, you just give point. Anyone who kicks a point, you give it to Dobson.
That's right, I do. Yeah. He's got 3-2 for the afternoon.
I think Tude gave that the old volleyball spike.
It was.
He's sort of gone like that.
And it was straight to Chris Jones. That was a thing. Lucky Jones missed it.
12-8-80 on the Blood Toyota scoreboard. St Mary's, 6-5-41 St Joey's, 19 played.
So it's measures. Almost 19 minutes gone. To say that Joey's need to get three goals in the next 10 minutes.
Not going
to
happen.
Not going to happen. No,
we said they're going to be within three goals at three-quarter time.
Yeah.
So.
Measures just up and under, out wide. Maloney was a target. Crummers at ground level. Was that Haints who stretched for that? It was. And the ball comes back out to Jones. Haints provides the tackle. Maloney goes back to give him a hand. Gets around. Kicks the ball, a wobbly one forward. Oh, Palliuris almost takes the mark, then drags it back in. Then he's tackled and slung to the ground.
Ooh,
umpire said, got him high. He quickly, Palliuris gives it to Haints. Haints across to Kelleher. Kelleher takes a bounce. Inside 50. Goes towards goal.
No.
Won't make the distance. Goes straight, hits Riley Hall.
That was a shocking kick.
I don't know why you do that.
Was it to an advantage or was it?
No.
Okay. He's been good, Paddy.
Yeah.
He's looked lively up forward.
Yeah, he has.
Find Snowden at half-back. Did Riley Hall. Snowden just content to go down the line. Had to sit under at Dobson, but his hands were excellent. Look at the one-on-one. Contest inside 50. It's Jones and Lovick. Jones got the sit. Here he goes up high. Jumped a bit too early, though. Nearly got to Lovick's back. Ball near the boundary and, in fact, finds it.
Lovick did a great job of not getting in the stepladder position there.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Sort of pulled the chair out of him.
And he's asking the umpire maybe for a free, but I'm not sure what for.
What was his intentions, he's saying? That's, you know, what else was he trying to do except step on my head?
Well, they hardly touched each other, did they?
Yeah. Yeah, he jumped way too early in the end. So it'll be thrown in 20 around from St Mary's' goal. The St Mary's goal, I should say.
Yeah.
Morrison clears it. Holmgren attacked it well. Couldn't quite take the mark. He ends up with it, though. Over the top looking for Palliuris. Couldn't quite find it. Neither could Arnell. He does now ground level via his boot, but the ball scrubbers out of play. 60 out from the St Mary's goal. And we'll have a throw in.
Yep, still 39 points. They trail St Joseph's. I would have thought come in favourite today.
Yep.
And haven't looked anything like it as Snowden knocks it down. Sherman kicks it. Kershaw takes the mark. Travellini takes it out of his hands. Old days.
Two umpires want to do it.
That's the old days. It's 50 every time if you touch it once a player marks it.
Old days.
Kershaw. In fact, when I played, gets it across to Haynes. No, they just changed the rules. Timmins on the weather. Oh, Jacko Davis goes with the one hand, then goes back. Tries to dish off the handball. Garner steals it, then gets it across to Bond, who gives it across to Sherman. Sherman, a little chip across to Gillies.
They got the extra here.
Gillies, he's got Dobson, which is by himself. Instead, Jones is in the goal square, says, kick it here, I'll mark it. Plays on, gets his fifth. Bang!
Well done.
Perfectly weighted kick to his advantage. But they just have that space, the one-on-one contest they get down there that St Joey's just don't have when they get into their forward 50.
Well, when you go forward and Jacko Davis is your key target, it's not going to happen for you, is it?
Yep. So on the Blood Toyota scoreboard, it's St Mary's, 13-8-86. They are defeating. They're not leading. They're defeating St Joseph, 6-5-41. 45-point margin now.
It's getting a bit dire for St Joey's. Everything they've tried isn't working.
Yeah. Ball back in the middle. This comes to ground. Ferguson tries to extract from the stoppage and gets a hold from the umpire too.
Well sold.
Carson hasn't come back on, has he, boys?
No. And you say you wouldn't bother.
Yeah, probably no point as well. Ferguson.
Haven't noticed a lot of Ferguson today either, boys.
No, he's been quiet.
Finds Treyer inside 50. Not a bad looking ball, actually, in the end.
Haven't noticed a lot of this bloke either. He hasn't been too bad, Haynes.
Yeah. Spent the last 3 weeks with Geelong and the VFL, Brent Haynes.
Really quiet in that second quarter.
Yep.
Sort of in and out this quarter.
Just his fifth match for St Joey's this season. But as we say, he's drifting in and out of this contest.
He's another on a tough kick.
Another one from the impossible angle.
From that pocket that's tough with this breeze. Gives it a pretty good go, actually. Just went late. Looked pretty good off the boot. But through for a behind for Brant Haynes. 23 minutes gone on the Blood Toyota scoreboard. St Joey's 6-5-41.
So Tenace, he finds McMahon. I reckon that is the Dylan McMahon. Goes, hugs the boundary line, goes wide. Dobson almost drags it in, measures, throws the head back looking for the free kick. Nothing doing, says the umpire. Boundary line seems wide enough to be out of bounds, but it's not. It's going to be a ball up. And it'll be out of bounds in about 2 seconds after this ball up. You watch. Throws it up.
One.
Yep, there you go. Hovey. There you go. Told you.
Just cast it straight over.
Tell me, I don't know what I'm talking about.
That was prophetic.
Yeah.
Very good, Milky. Yeah. Comes back in. Right on centre wing, out of side. Snowden got rid of Hobie pretty easily in the end. No,
been doing that
kick.
A bit today.
Yeah, and been getting away with it.
Yeah, Connors.
Just been throwing him away.
The ground level was stripped of it by a few Joeys, including Ryan Williams. But the umpire folds the arms and throw up. So, yes, go on, guys.
No, you're right, mate. It's probably been one of those games that we've seen, the first game this year I've seen where they've been exposed in the ruck, without a ruckman, without a genuine ruckman, St Joseph's.
Yeah, for sure.
You're right.
All at ground level. Arnell.
It happened against Newtown early in the season. We're Fanning won them the game against Newtown against Joeys, but that's about it. Usually Hovey can at least hold his own around the stoppage and then hurt you around the ground, but he hasn't done either today.
No, they've certainly been good in that area, St Mary's.
The ball's 60 out from home for St Joeys. on the far side. We've played 24, nearly 25 minutes on the Blood Toyota scoreboard. Third term, Williams is third up. Couldn't quite make contact. Kick came out of the pack. Pitches short of the boundary. And it'll be thrown in again.
I think that was Fazio, just threw his boot at it in the middle of the pack. 25, just ticked over. Spinning ball, out of side. This game's over, guys. Trust me.
Yep,
I'd say ball so. Out the back, Etherton dishes off the handball. Quick hands, back to McMahon. Bouncing ball, Fazio tries to get through. Measures, tries to wrap up his opponent there in Connors. Or Killen, I'm sorry. And the ball's in dispute. Measures gets up very slowly and we'll have a ball up right
on. You just feel sort of the intensity's just been sapped out of it at the moment. It's just a bit sort of, let's get to three-quarter time and figure something out from there.
I don't think they can figure it. There's not much they can give them another three-quarters and they still wouldn't figure it out at this stage. Ball comes out to Snowden. Snowden dishes off, ducks under the tackle, which that's really, that's the holding ball the ball, umpire, but hence they're in a different planet to us, these boys. That was just ridiculous. He ducked out of the tackle and then still got time to get rid of the ball.
Yeah.
It hasn't really serious. I'm been pretty quiet on the uppies this year, but this has been an ordinary effort for a final.
Yeah, mad Monday for them.
Comes in, Hovey won the tap at the front position. It's probably holding the footy. Speaking of the
same
umpires,
thing, he's
rookie.
Holding the footy. Holding the ball.
That was holding the ball against Williams.
If you got trigger boy, if he wants to, look at him.
Yep.
He let me out
up,
of
the other
of
way.
In the back of the centre square, Snowden throws a fist at it. Didn't really go anywhere. Hands were good from Tudor. Handball over the top. They get a run on here. St. Joey's kick inside 50. Oh, that's a brilliant bit of defending.
It was terrific
from,
defending.
Tom Lang
it was.
The young boy, and they win the ball back too. Handball for Cole out of his defensive half. Should have been chopped off by Haynes. Dropped the mark he probably should have taken in the end. Ball's at half forward. The umpire will cross the arms and will throw it in. So Tom Lang did terrifically. Won a best on ground middle in the losing cause in the interleague game for the 19s this year. Milky playing at fullback.
Yeah, he did.
Excellent talent. I've seen him play forward for some ages here and kick four in one game. I saw he's good at both ends. Good football.
Well, umpire goes down. Do as a favour and stay down as the ball bounces. the boundary line. And we'll have a throw in.
And cheers of concur went around.
cheerio to everyone out there listening. We're sorry that the level of the call hasn't been that great because it's been a damn ordinary game. Maloney traps it from the throw-in. St. Mary's have just been way too good on this occasion. Ball comes back out to Cole. He's been a super find for the St. Mary's boys. Snowden crashes his way through. Old happy feet, he'd be a happy man. Comes back to Super Joe. He can't get through. Ball is going a metre at a time. There's been four kicks in there and they've all gone a metre. Fazio traps it. Umpire finally blows the whistle and says, give it to me.
Super Joe just causing a bit of havoc in there.
No love lost between the Catholics.
That's right. He's at this stoppage too. Super Joe got to get on the move. Modern up with this too as well. Doesn't quite. He goes to ground. He was bundled over. The handball for Ferguson misses him and the ball's out of play. Centre wing broadcast side. We've played 28 minutes. Blood Toyota scoreboard. St. Mary still convincing leaders. 13-8, 86 to 6-6, 42.
Spinning ball. In it comes. Snowden gets a front spot. Then he gives and he gives 2-1 right around the chops.
He's not happy.
So, free kick to Tudor. What's he going to do? Got to move it quickly. Just gives the St. Mary's boys time to go back. It goes in there. Oh, chopped off by Dougie Bond, was it? And then did he? I thought he grabbed his shoulder on that stage. Verfurth goes forward. Oh, it's all St. Mary's.
Yeah.
Just Riley Hall gives it across to McMahon. Crumbs go back to Riley Hall. Hultgren's there. Can he trap it? Hall spins round three times. Off a step. Arnell goes and gets a much-needed goal.
It's on again.
Who's at the who's at ground level? Hultgren.
Never short of a word to say.
Loves it. Like his vigour.
Don't think anything will come of that.
Nope.
It's Riley Hall to seem to get a bit disoriented. Then I don't think he realised how close he was to the line. He could have.
Probably one of his few mistakes for the day.
He's been very good.
I don't think he expected it to be a call play on touch when he took the mark as well. So
Rolly Hall's been terrific down there.
Yeah. Ball back in the middle. Neither ruckman got a hand to it. The umpire's plucked a free kick out of there, though.
Or something.
Going the way of Snowden. Give his quicker to Cole. We've mentioned a lot today. He nearly just got the speed wobbles there, though.
He got stuck
in the cricket.
Has played
a good game. Snowden was met solidly. Cole was probably held without it.
Absolutely.
Man, have I ever seen one to St. Mary's?
goes wide towards Arnell. The ball's at half forward out of sight. Chesty. Brilliantly done by Palliuris. The Greek god goes from half forward and hits the post. That probably would have rivaled Zach Sherman for goal of the day.
Been a bit quiet on marks today.
We haven't had one. This afternoon, but
we have had marks, we just haven't had contenders.
Haven't had an absolute ripper.
So McMahon in the goal square goes out wide. Good mark.
Best one, yeah.
So I reckon it's.
Is that killing?
Was that killing? I reckon it was killing. Oh, Benny Kappa uses his body, gets it out. Oh, Dougie Bond shows a clean pair, taps it in the path of Jones. Kenny can't keep it in. And the ball will be thrown in. 40 around. No, that's probably on the paint. It's probably 50 out. From the St Mary's goal. They lead on the Blood Toyota scoreboard, 13-8-86 to 7-7-49.
Been impressed with Killen today. I haven't seen him before, and he's shown something.
Had a shot after the sign in the Interleague game to win it for them in the under-19s. Yep. Kirsch and missed it.
Okay.
Won't be happy about you bringing that one up.
No, he won't like that at all.
Finals
campaign back on track.
He's got a lot of talent, as we've seen today.
Yeah, he has.
Tackle is near the boundary, and we'll do it all again. 65 out from home for St Mary. So dying embers this third term. 31 gone.
31 gone.
On the Blood Toyota score. We had that little hold up before, but wasn't too long. Kick smothered, goes near the boundary, measures, falls over, and it's still in. Kept in by Fazio. Ball pitches on end. Lovick's happy to usher that.
He just threw it out of bounds. Just heaved it over rugby style.
Ball's inside 50 for St Mary's, 35 out.
Spinning ball.
Eventually.
Get the thing in. Yep, there it goes. Oh, Tudor. Good use of the body on Jones. Goes a bit of a round the body type kick, but it's picked up by Gillies, who runs straight into the tackle. He's gone. Advantage. Paid to Jacko Davis. His kick smothered straight away. Cole, he's wrapped up in the tackle. Umpire says, you're gone. Now it goes back to Hultgren, but the kick's to Davis. Davis goes very, very wide to Maloney. Can he trap it? He does. Maloney, Hovey's in the goal square. Super Joe's there as well. Gone over, or both their heads. Fisted to ground. McMahon dishes off the handball to his twin brother. Then it comes off a step. Capra versus Dobson. Oh. Gets hands on it. Oh, Zach Morrison's there. Dobson's still there. Held when he didn't have it, I reckon. Oh, in the middle of the back. Oh, gee whiz, he come back onto the ground. The big fella in Banjanin. Ball goes back to McMahon, dishes off, comes back to Garner. Come and get me, he says. Handball's around, bit of candy. Surely he's gone. But siren blows. Three-quarter time.
Give him the mark of the day for that little...
Yes. So at three-quarter time, St Mary's, 13-8-86. Umpire holds it aloft.
Here we go.
Umpire holds it aloft to get this thing over. Up we go. Neither Ruckman win that. Tudor or Banjanin. Tudor goes back, gets a ball round the body, into the hot spot. Hultgren tries to get it with one hand. Hovey's down there, then he kicks it out to Jacko Davis. Needs a good bounce, goes towards goal, got the quick one. 16 seconds that took.
Wow.
Jeez, the fans are up and about.
Come on, boys. Still think they're a chance.
The message must have got them thinking they're in it.
7-7-49.
Well, that was 21 seconds.
Yep. 16 it was, in fact. By the
was it 16?
I looked exactly at the clock when it went through. 16 seconds.
Well, if they were five down at three-quarter time, you'd sort of give them a chance. And now it's basically three-quarter time, they're five goals down. So
sort of give them a theory, chance.
Well, keep that up, Barnsley. You can go over and talk to the coaches and keep them interested, will you?
If I ever coach again, Barnsley, I'm going to have you with me. That's your right-hand man.
How much am I getting on that one?
McCullough gets it out of the guts. Goes back into the Ryan Williams territory. Williams needs to hit a target. Clears the pack over Maloney's head. Back there is Wade. Gives it across to Tanace. Tanace, a little give to McMahon. That's Hayden. Haven't even said once about he needs a haircut and a shave today because he's been too damn good.
Yeah. This is where they've been good, St Mary's.
Spears it in.
That's no exception.
Yeah. Oh. He's got Cole again. He's calling his teammates. Come to me, he's saying.
Beautiful kick.
Why not? Oh, gee, should have marked that, young son. Was that Killen? Yep. Perhaps left that one. Comes back to Measures. Measures has got it on centre wing. Needs to attack. Found Super Joe.
Got a wheel and go here.
Super Joe, he had Dreyer and he's ignored him. Dreyer was on his own, so he kicked it into a pack situation. Hultgren dishes off.
Free kick going the way.
Free kick to Williams.
No, give it to Super Joe. Imagine what Super Joe can do right now.
Right now, get him.
That's probably over his distance here, I'd say,
Ryan. Right on his limit.
But he's looking. He just looked to see. He speared it in to Haynes. Good kick. Clever use of the footy.
That Illinois Bryce Vincent. It took a lot of time to go back then, Ryan Williams, and they didn't plug the gap.
And it's what they've been really
good goals.
At. What they've been really good at all day.
It's Kirsch's paperwork. Goes everywhere in the breeze. Reaching down.
Oh, dear. They've been really good at that, not allowing those, you know, the easy entries, the easy exits, all that sort of stuff.
Game was over. Haynes kicks and kicks. A goal.
Hey. How's your theory going, Barnsley?
What if there were four goals down at three-quarter time? What would we be thinking?
Is it nearly three?
Two and a half minutes gone, so it's still pretty much quarter time, and they're down to four. Couldn't possibly, could they?
You wouldn't have thought.
Would not a chance.
It feels like they believe the way they've been celebrating those goals.
Do you know what the difference is, boys? Just that quick kick, that quick movement again. Absolutely. Doesn't give St Mary's that time to set up and get their structures in play.
And because they've won it out of the middle.
Exactly right.
Won it out of the middle twice. Yeah. 13-8-86 on the blood to the Godding score, I'm sorry. St Joey's 9-7-61, 25 points. Nearly the closest they've been.
There it is
as it comes out again to Jacko Davis.
High up and under ball too from Davis inside 50.
He's got a free kick. No, he played it.
It was a good dive. Yeah. Almost had me convinced. Yeah.
It was a bit of a flop from Hovey.
It's good by Hebbard though.
Clearing kick from Hebbard. Didn't get a good piece of it and helped over by Harry Cole.
Some funny how football can do. A couple of goals, four inside 50s in a row, four clearances. And all of a sudden, the tails are up.
Joey's will start to think that we can, and some others will think that we couldn't possibly.
Well, just important to keep hands.
He's saved all his
zingers
for the finals.
He has, hasn't he?
What do you mean? I was pretty good earlier.
He's come loaded. Tudor wins it down. Tried to get a Palieris. Super Joe, just the quick inside 50. Call against McCullough. Did pretty well. Hebbard, handball over the top.
Oh, they caught each other.
Joey's players got in each other's way. Sherman allowed to clear the footy. Firth just blocks his man out of it, allows Messers to take the mark. He's inside the centre square, looking for the options.
Again.
Yeah, he's just a little bit slow, Dan Messers. Going his opposite foot, left foot ball. Over
the
top. That's
great mark. There it is. There it is.
Nearly going
down. That's the contender at the stage.
That's a genuine contender.
It's just another waste of an inside 50, really.
It was, so he went wide, it was Lang.
Sorry, that was Lang, who went outside, so had a bit of the sneezes, so to stop there, the ball comes out, overrunning it, was Tudor, ball comes at all, he had that spent, Cole, then he ducks his head, gets it clear, ball comes out the back, McMahon, dishes off to Garner, who seems to have all the time in the world, gets it back to his teammate, good spoil there from Measures on Dobson. Ball comes back into the hot spot. Great kick to Gillies.
Got man in the goal square.
Was that Dougie Bond that kicked that? I'm trying to pick who that player is. Right on the far side with the shoulders strapped.
Yeah, it is, I think. 13, is it?
Can't see. He's just bending over. Connors, maybe.
Killen? Oh, Killen.
Killen, was it?
Shoulder strapping.
He has been killing it. Good vision.
At this point, you didn't get that one first, Milky. Killing it.
Yes.
That's right up your other way.
Gillies comes in to have a shot at the 14th goal. Breeze seems to have died off. He puts it straight over the goal umpire's hat.
They'd be disappointed with that. Six inside 50s to one.
Yeah.
They go down and kick goal.
Yeah.
Just deflate
some. Just take the wind out of the sails, doesn't it? Yep. So on the Godding scoreboard, that's 14-8-92. To St Mary's at the 5.5 minute mark. They lead St Joey's 9-7-61. Back out to 31 points.
You can backtrack it probably to that measure's taken too long and then having to rush on his left.
He had that chance to wheel 50. Around inside on his right and go deep, and he just didn't.
So back in the middle. Boy, again, Tudor jumps way too early. Ben Shannon took it out of the ruck. Probably could have been ping pong in the footy. Reese, anyway, gets it inside 50 looking for Williams. Couldn't take the mark. Fellow 14 Hall got the footy.
That's deliberate.
That's
and then
deliberate.
Tenace was under a lot of pressure, but the ball does go out of bounds.
Show some maggots, umpire.
He had a teammate 40 metres away.
He's done nothing but go to the boundary line.
He kicked it directly
across. Surely that's the spirit
line.
Of the law. That is the spirit of the law.
Comes
that's why they brought it in.
On the plane of 50, Holgren over the top of Ben Shannon, nearing the boundary. Williams just scraps after it. His handball was clear. Kicking back inside 50. There's a mark taken. Wade was just brought down without it. And free kick is
pays that one
to him. A true
as the Joey's supporters let him know.
Yeah, well, probably rightly so.
Wade goes short to about 50.
Oh, good strong mark.
He started strong
Ryan
in this
Williams.
Quarter.
Yeah, he stood
looks
up,
good
goes
up
across.
Oh,
no.
There it is again,
just
the turnover.
Coughed it up, and coughed Lang, it up again.
Lang at half back, just swooped across ahead of Super Joe and intercepted. He kicks into the middle of the ground looking for Jones. Capra has a fly! And nearly took the mark. Didn't come down with it. Just bounces up, though.
Missed it again.
Kick to Rees. Misses the target. Williams just barrels through. Bowls over three in the process.
Umpire circling. Oh, no.
Not sure why Capra didn't just handball that.
Yeah. Paddy Callagher is a runner.
He tried to do a dinky little chip. Just handball it to him.
Yep. Good call, Barnsley. Up they go again by Van Janen. Just a little weird-ass kick there from him.
As grabbed the
Burford. Burford just kicks it. Then a barrel goes towards Lubbock. Or gets a sideways bounce. Jones dishes it off to Garner, who run this all the way. Will he give it a travel? Any? Gets stuffed, he says. I'm kicking it. Walks in, kicks the sealer. Game over. If it wasn't already three-quarter time.
Got a feel for Travellini there. He was ahead of the pack the whole way, screaming for it, and Garner just ran past him.
You just can't make that many mistakes on a day like today, can you?
And made plenty of them. 15-8-98. Will they get the ton, St Mary's? They lead St Joey's 9-7-61. Back out to 37 points, and that's the margin it was at three-quarter time.
Yep.
You reckon the nervous 90s exist in footy, do you, Milky?
Oh, yeah, they do. Yeah. See if they can raise their bat. The line there, I nearly spat it out too, but I just didn't. I left it alone.
So, 8 minutes played.
Godding scoreboard too, by the way.
Spot on, Milky.
Cats won by a lazy 111.
111?
Oh, yeah.
Paul Roos's biggest defeat in his career, that one.
Was it?
Oh,
really?
His last game.
Yep.
Barnsley, pull the one out of that.
Good boy.
Probably Paul. Made it up where you wouldn't know any different.
That's exactly right.
He's stripping out it. Garner does well. Spins out of trouble, I believe, you, Barnsley. That's okay. Morrison's got the sit. Takes a really good mark. Let's go in down in my book too, Milky.
Yeah, put that down. One in. We don't have many.
That took a bit of courage. You take it away.
Yeah, that was probably the better one. But that's the best mark of the day, I think, Morrison. Under. Oh, then he mungs it.
Boy.
Mungs
it. Of the day.
Then Kershaw got
what
two
way
to
was
beat.
That spinning?
Snowden dishes off to Travellini. Travellini back to McMahon. McMahon back to Snowden. He's beat her out. Boundary umpire says you were out of bounds, son. We're going to have a throw in. I reckon Paddy Dangerfield was 3 metres further out than that when he kicked that goal, by the way.
Still going
just
on
quietly,
about
boys.
That.
Just quietly.
Let it go.
No. Just a spinning ball coming in. I've got more to say about that as the ball comes out. Garner, kick off the side of the boot to the outer side. Bouncing. Verfith there. So too. I reckon that was Dobson. Knocks it down. Comes out Cole, who's been fantastic. Verfith dishes it over. Palliuris taps it into the path of Keller. He takes a bounce. No, he doesn't. Then he spears it long into the Maloney direction. Oh. Takes the mark. Yes, he does. 15 out.
Keller has showed a bit, Kersh.
He has. He's been probably one of their better players in the second half of this game. In fact, probably all overall, really. That second quarter, he breathed a little life into their forward line, and he's got a bit of run and carry going this quarter.
Maloney's got one. He's now got one still. 1-2 for the day. Should have kicked three goals. The two he's missed have both been in that exact same spot.
Yeah, easy shots.
You don't miss from there.
Nah.
I guess he did.
Also to Jack Darling last night, I guess. He was a little bit closer and more in front.
9-8-62. St. Joseph, they trail St. Mary's. 15-8-98. Six-goal margin.
Yeah.
Hall in the back pocket. 10.5 minutes played. Just slows things up. Happy to go down the line towards Gillies and Morrison. But Dobson showed some nice hands in front of the pack. Really sticky mitts. And Dobson is at a pretty handy
Demi Grant, stop walking past distracting us.
Dobson just goes down the line looking for Gillies again.
Turn up that creepy radar there.
It's a mate of mine's daughter, mate. That's all good. It's all good.
Creepdar was up.
Yay. Don't go there. Don't go there. Got three kids, three grandkids, and five stepkids. Yep. So, you know, no room for any others.
And the police helicopter's still there. Paul comes back in. Ben Shannon wins it down. Goes to St. Joey's, though. Haynes was stripped of it and just burst clear. Did pretty well. Finds Callahoo, spins out of trouble. Found some time where there was none. But Zach Sherman, a man here you don't want to turn the footy over to, gets it a half back, goes towards Travellini and Kershaw. Travellini brings it to ground. Tenace is there, just chipping ball over the top. Dobson and Lovey, good contest that one. Lovey got a fist in. Verfurth at ground level, pressured by Paddy Killen. Got to be careful, he dived on it. Did Verfurth, and he is
gone. He gone.
That one's out of the textbook.
Yeah.
I understand that one.
Yeah, you do. Yep, that's actually how they're supposed to be paid.
Yep, I understand that one.
So, I think it is Paddy Killen. It is who will take the resulting free kick. One of the young brigade that have led St Mary's this year, and showed a bit this afternoon on the slightly bigger stage as well.
Good at fourth quarter set shots, according to Buzz.
Tom Lang. Oh, yes. Tom Lang coming on. Has he got anything to worry about?
Yeah, I think so.
Yep. Yeah, I reckon he does.
Yep.
Bit of a shame. He's been good today.
I did say Josh Hovey had nothing to worry about earlier on in the year too.
Yeah.
But I think he's got a lot to worry about.
Paddy
Killen. Josh Hovey got 2 weeks for that.
Yeah.
Comes in. Yet to kick a senior goal too, Milky.
Oh, he still is.
And still with that one goes right across
good
the
mark.
Face.
That's a nice
really good
that's
mark.
That's Hovey.
By Hovey.
Contenders are coming. Good.
In
good
the back
post. You want to put that down, Buzz, or not?
I'll put it down for you.
Elite Training Centre.
Yeah, the Elite Training. They've been good all year, Elite Training Centre. Hovey goes to the outer side, looking for Verfeth. Good use of the body, but he's got Morrison there to help him. He almost tripped Morrison over. Gets around Bond, ditches off the handball and measures. They haven't stopped trying, St. Joey's. Give him that. There's six goals down. Goes down the line.
To no one.
Sherman's there. Gave it to Palioris. Palioris dances around a couple. Then he kicks it into their backside. Sherman. Back to Palioris. Got time to have a shot at goal here. Oh, just would have been great for that to be a goal, though, wouldn't it?
Well,
in fact, it was a minor score. 2-2.
Odd stuff going on out there.
Absolutely.
It's been an odd day, Kirsch.
It's only going to get worse,
Buzz,
let me tell you.
Summed it up.
Yeah.
So McMahon, Dylan, to bring it in.
He's got him! The old Trigger Boy!
He goes, I haven't been in it for a while. I need to get back in the game, Trigger Boy.
The stupidest rule in the game. Unless you're taking a massive advantage by running out of the square, what difference does it make?
You have to draw the line somewhere, and they literally do.
So it'll be thrown up on the point of the square. Ben Shannon takes it out of the ruck. Tenace clears it. Bounces near another number nine in Dreyer. Bounces clear of him. Allen.
Great contest.
Was bundled over the boundary by Dobson, who's played a good game of footy.
It was 3-on-1 over that side of the ball got kicked to Dobson, and he managed to get it over the boundary line for a 50-50 ball in. Like, that's just, they've been winning those sort of small contests that they aren't supposed to win against the Joey's back line.
Yeah.
They've halved a lot of contests today. Been a feature of their game. Banjan had a front spot, won it down to another number 12, Allen. Dumped inside 50 by Dreyer. It spirals near the boundary. Sherman over the top. Nearly took a mark over Arnell. Palioris, his hands were good at ground level. Arnell just darts out of trouble. That was brilliantly done and finds Kelleher.
That was a good play.
45 out.
Have a shot.
Where's that been all day?
Have a shot.
Plays on, wheels round, kicks right from the paint of 50, right to the edge of goal.
And gets one. Deserved it.
And he gives a little verbal ear massage to McMahon on the way past, which I like.
You do like that stuff.
Done. Yes. 10-9, they move on to 69. St. Joey's, St. Mary's, 15-8, 98. That's on the Godding scoreboard. We've nearly played 15 minutes in the last term.
In fact, we've played 14 minutes and 54 seconds. Is that nearly?
I said nearly.
The back down to under five goals. They kick five goals now.
I'll tell you what, if she said three quarters and a half, what would you say?
Well, they do say goal per minute, doesn't like Matthews, but...
Up they go. Hovey wins this one. Super Joe tackled without it, but he umpire got that right. Ball comes out. Tenace is in the middle. He tackles Williams. Umpire circling.
Trigger Boy may have, but not him.
Yeah. So Tenace, he's been everywhere today.
They got the plus one down here with Sherman.
So they swap those two over, I think, as the ball comes out the back. Cop one high to Jacko Davis. The ball comes out. Arnell can't trap it.
There it is.
Riley Hall. There, the man gives it over to Hebbard. Sherman, that was. Gives it over to Hebbard. Hebbard, a little chip across to Cole. Is it? Yes. It is Cole, isn't it? With
That's him.
19, you reckon he is. He's been sensational.
Looks like he's played 100 games, doesn't
he? Whose son is he?
Michael's.
Michael Cole goes up the line. Oh, Snowden. Is it?
Dobson.
Dobson out of side.
It's really...
They seem to have been too tall for me today, St. Mary's. As it comes back to Cole.
He's at half back.
I reckon Joey's got to equalise here and not allow them to have that spare. Just go man on man.
Yeah, why not at this
stage? Absolutely. Yeah. Don't worry about having the plus one behind the ball.
Dobson.
Got to go for broke.
Yeah.
Gets Lovick up the ground. That's something they've done well today. I'll get your thoughts on it after the game. Curse have engaged Lovick.
Yep.
Played through him a little bit. Ball inside 50. Morrison got a fist in. Filters out of the pack. Killen just tries to get a kick away, but it was smothered and over the line and out right on the paint of 50. Out of side, long way away out there.
It is, and it's getting dark, and that's why you've handballed it to me. Buzz, that's not normally the go. I normally do that shit.
That's right.
So the spinning ball out of side. Up they go. Banjanin to Lovick. Oh, and he fumbles. Then dishes off the handball. Tudor over to Measures. Measures around the body. Finds Sherman. Sherman, little quick one. Goes hard. Bond is the target. He's got Hippalurus chasing him. Doug's the call. But chipping in. Oh, chipping him. Cop the chop. He's Jacko Davis. Plays on. Yeah, I don't think he can. Plays on, but he gets it in Maloney territory. But going back, the young fella in Jack Henderson takes a really nice mark.
Can't have advantage from your own kick.
No. He's on centre wing, goes all the way back to Zach Sherman at centre half back, who switches the play further to Hebbard. He's got some time and space to go into if he wants, but he just sits and milks a bit of time off the clock. Chipping ball for Cole is nice, who marks on centre wing out of side. He's played a very good game of footy.
He's played a really good game for just a youngster.
Just a second senior game for Harry Cole, made his debut last week. Certainly got a lot of potential there.
Yes,
bit of dash too, which I like, inside 50. And the mark is taken.
Garner.
It is Jared Garner. Yep. Attacked it well.
There's a bit of disdain for his opponents there.
Yep. Positive ball movement. It's been St Mary's' go all afternoon. They've done it superbly as well. Jared Garner's got a chance for his third goal of the afternoon. St Mary's is 16th too, and another chance to crack the ton as well. He comes in, he'll kick from about 35 out.
Breeze has dropped, has it, or not?
Yeah, a little bit.
I reckon it seems to have.
Out of side, Jared Garner doesn't get much of it. Very, very narrow. Through for a behind.
2-1 for the afternoon to Jared Garner. It's Kershaw to kick out. The old man's a bit nervous. Yeah. Kicks it wide. Finds his teammate in Davis. Goes towards Maloney. Got two to beat. Two cracks at it. Lovick's at the bottom of the pack. Rolls over the footy. And then Dougie Bond is happy to see it tumbled over the boundary line. We'll have a throw in. 5 goals is the margin. At the 19-minute mark. It was game over, I reckon, near almost a quarter time. Just about, boys. They just
We waited for Joe's to get going, and they never really
set
did.
Up a 27-point margin, and that's probably going to appear to be what the end result will be, very close to that. Round the corner goes Travellini, and he finds Fazio. Fazio goes into centre for Dobson. Can he get a good bounce back there to Measures, who does set St Joey's free? Dreyer bounce, gets a crook one, has to go back. Then did he get one high? No, says the umpire. Ball Palliuris in there to help him. Is that Sherman in there fighting for St Mary's? It is. Ball comes out. Oh, gee whiz. I don't know what he did with that. Did he handball it and then backslap it? Ball comes over at the top to Dougie Bond. He gives it over to McMahon. He puts on the afterburners, then just kicks a big mung into the forward 50. Dobson. Oh, lands on his ass and slides over the boundary line. We'll have a throw in.
It was just another 2-on-1 contest over the outer side. Yep. St Mary's were the one, and they won it.
Two Joey's boys went to ground.
Yeah. Just remarkable. Those are kind of things Joey's would usually just pick up and scoot away from.
Yep. 45 out, broadcast side, ball out the back. Fazio got a snap on goal. Pitches on end. Dobson wanted the free kick, and he might even get one in the back. No, says the umpire. Travellini attacked hard on the line. Capra with a little swinging arm as well.
Came in there late. Just late and low.
Tactical. And the ball will be thrown up.
Letting him know.
Right on the boundary's edge. 15 around from goal. A lot of players on their haunches at the moment. Sam Dobson limping away from this contest. Don't know what's going on here. There's a little argument between Gillies and the umpire. Probably saying he probably should just throw it in for the sake of it.
By the hooter, he's probably saying.
Just spins out of trouble. Falls to Garner. He kicks for goal. Narrow again. Jared Garner.
Raise that bat, Milky.
2-2.
There it is, yes. A lot of Saturdays the bat gets raised. As the ball is coming out of the goal square, Kershaw goes to the outer side. A big mung floater. Zach Morrison nearly has his arm ripped out of its socket. Ball comes out clearly to Palliuris. The rebound goes through to Fazio. Fazio across to his teammate there in Connors. Connors kicks it wide to Wade. He gets just wrapped up in a tackle by Lovick. Across to Jones. Jones into the hot spot. Oh, going back, Tudor taking mark. Plays on. Oh, gee, they're playing on quick. Gives it to Kershaw. Takes a bounce. Then dishes off the handball. Goes to Palliuris. Palliuris across to Jacko Davis. Davis just kicks it wide for Holcren. Oh, going and taking a good
great
mark.
Great chase by McMahon there. Got a hand in there to affect the kick.
Yeah, just did enough there for Etherton to just reach across. Hultgren, he just about got Sherman too. And gives him an ear polish on the way up.
I think he gave him a little something.
He did. He tries to crash his way through, does Hultgren, and we'll have a ball up right in front of the kicks commentary truck.
I think you worried Sherman too much.
Nah.
Yeah, doesn't look too fast.
Nah, Sherman just gets up and goes about his business.
That's it.
The ball right on the paint.
Troops.
Yep, right on the paint of 50, directly in front of us. 22 minutes played on the Godding scoreboard last term. Snowden puts the fist through it. It'll fall to Dre, who'll be first to it. Spins back onto his right boot and just dumps a high up and under footy to about 48 out from home. No flyers could mark the footy. Connor's under some pressure. Showed some composure, though, towards Verfirth. Goes in one arm. That one was held by Garner. Ball at ground level with Bond, who's happy to see it over on centre wing.
22 and a half gone. 100 plus 69. 31-point margin here.
Yep.
It is game over, and Tudor has front spot. Slaps it down. Comes back. Super Joe. Round the body he goes, bouncing ball, bouncing to Palioris, was going to give off the handball, then decides to go towards Haynes, doesn't get him, Jones is there, Haynes keeps his feet, he's got a mate there, should have given it across to him, but Haynes dishes off the handball, Arnell was there to help Sherman, dishes off to Snowden, the old happy feet, gets it wide to the man himself in Hebbard, Matty Hebbard goes wide again, finds Travellini out of wing.
It's another ball they missed through that corridor of the ground, isn't it?
Arnell went past, he should have given it to him straight away.
Yeah.
Travellini providing the last bits of light for the afternoon via his boots. Fisted out of play on centre wing.
They get brighter, don't they? Joe's boots are bloody.
They're just rather luminous at the moment.
They are, aren't they?
But not necessarily a bad
Gillies
thing.
Gillies aren't the next colour down, are they?
Gillies, next shade. They're probably rolling the same. Yeah. Oh, they are a different shade of green. You're right, Milky.
Oh, yeah.
Back in.
The eyes are still good.
Centre wing. Just Banjanin dominantly in the ruck. Cole just weaved away through in some traffic. Ended up turning it over though. Ball to about 60 out. Trying to burst through was Lang. He was beaten to it. Haynes at ground level tries to break a tackle. Does so. Kelleher gives it back now. 55 out. Just kicks long and high. Is that Mezzers running back with a flight? The ball pitches on its end.
But if he hadn't touched it,
it would have come back in.
Yeah, if he hadn't touched it, it would have gone back in. He would might have had time then. Give that one to Maloney, will we? Gives him 1-3 for the day. So Sherman now kicking out. Decides to go to McMahon. He gives it. Oh, was about to give it off, then changed his mind. Finds Henderson. Right in front of us here. Gee, he's young. He's not even shaving yet, this kid. I'm sure of it. No. Goes up towards Jones. Fisted away from him by Maloney. Ball goes to Cole. Oh,
brilliant.
Cole just look at that to Banjanin. Finds him, laces out. Big Banjo. Dishes off the handball. To Fazio.
Oh, yes,
goes
please.
Towards goal. Oh. The wind. No. Minor score.
Could have raffled that one.
Yep.
Had a couple of blokes running in. Bond particularly was just going to throw into the goal square.
I thought that car didn't have a handbrake on for me. I thought she was in free fall. I thought Benny Capron might have been a bit of strife, but just reversing away from this one. Fisted out of play, about 60 out from home. We've played 25 minutes on the Godding scoreboard.
Doesn't want to make you laugh as long as it makes you laugh. Buzz, that wasn't bad.
I generally thought that was
I'm just looking at all the kids. Is there something going on up there? We're all looking towards the cards. None of them watching the footy.
Ball out the back. No ruckman to get a hand to it. Numbers round it. Williams went hard at the footy. He attracts a crowd pretty quickly. You know, boy, folds the arms and we'll do it all again. Centre wing out of sight. 101 plays 70. St Mary's in the lead. They've been dominant this afternoon. And speaking of, Banjanin won it down pretty comfortably. Only as far as Rees, who's stripped of it and holding the footy.
Young Henderson, wasn't it, that got him?
Thank you. It might be right, Milky.
Yeah.
Good tackle by the young man. Look, Brenton Rees hasn't had
looking at the coaching staff here to our left, mate, scratching their heads.
Yeah. Yep. They've got some work ahead of them, St. Joey's, that's for sure.
Unfamiliar position.
Absolutely. Yep. Henderson drives it down the line. Looked for Snowden. Fell short of him. They're happy to see it over. And we'll throw it in again, 55 out.
Certainly not going to chalk it up to an easy win next week either against either Bell Park or Grove.
No, hell no. No.
Spinning ball comes in. Banjanin just ragdolls Tudor. Balls at ground level. Super Joe's in there. Can't pick it up. Stacks on. Ferguson in there to lend a hand. Coming up Fazio for St Mary's.
St Mary's been fantastic.
Their
young kids have been absolutely brilliant.
In their first final, a lot of them have just been outstanding.
And so tap down from Banjo to Garner, who Does he put it out in the full? He doesn't. They're calling out in the full.
Oh, one's saying yes, one's saying no.
Free kick off Lovick.
Yep, that's what he's paid.
He's paid the free kick off Lovick. Oh, dear. So the free kick goes to Paddy Killen.
Jesus, this would be a goal and a half if he kicks this.
The boundary umpire called on the full.
Yep.
And the central umpire overruled him.
Okay.
Is that right?
Paddy Killen comes in, misses.
There's no one on the line.
On the line. Yeah.
No, I think that Jones pushed Lovick into the footy and it come off his leg and went out in the full.
So they go quickly, Joey's. Tudor kicks to about 60 out. Capra was up high, couldn't hold the mark for St. Joey's. Filters back to McMahon, who just scrubbers one inside 50. Not many there to speak of. Killen wrapped up quickly just inside the arc and will throw it up directly in front. Nearly 28 gone in this last term then.
Scoreboard's nice and bright.
This one just petering out in this first final of the GFL final series. Bond has harassed Kelleher out of it. McMahon lays a strong tackle and will ball it up again.
Be interesting. I think other than the St Mary's heroics, it's been an ordinary game of footy, so it'll be interesting to see how the Geelong Advertiser reporter reports on this game.
Yeah. Fantastic game of footy, I'd say. Don't know what the reporter would say.
Comes to out of the pack to about 60 out. Williams forced to hold his ground. Gets a kick away towards Palliuris, beaten to it by McMahon. And Effenden ushers it over.
Just so many of St. Joseph's big players have been down. Oh,
absolutely.
Yeah, I have hardly called some of their names. Allen hasn't had a touch.
Yep. Just
so many of them.
Measures is at full forward.
Yep.
Didn't see that one spinning coming. Ball. No, spinning, but they're just trying anything. Yeah. Spinning. Ben Jennon flips it over. Kelleher again. Fast becoming Joey's, probably almost Joey's best player.
Yep.
Gets it again. Knocks it down. Fazio's in there. So to McMahon. Wrapped up by Jacko Davis. Super Joe's in there as well. He gets a ball, boot on the ball. Bouncing ball. The two fives go at it. Etherton just happy to slide across the line. We'll have a throw in. I think out of this game, St Mary's go in chock full of confidence for the rest of the final series.
Yeah, why wouldn't you?
Against Leopold next week. Should be a cracking contest.
No bigger scalp than knocking the reigning premier off, that's for sure, in the first final. Travellini snaps towards Killen. His hands were quick, just allowing a path on goal. Tenace was handballed to under pressure and was wrapped up quickly.
Thing he hasn't done is kicked a goal.
Who?
Tenace.
Yeah.
And he's been backed as well in the process.
Too. Oh, hey. Well, see, there's something else he hadn't happened. That's happened as well.
Plays on. They've just rushed. I don't know why they decided to play on St. Joey's. Verfurth goes wide to Lovick.
Oh.
Who handballs over.
Real
sort of hospital kind of pass. Super Joe made it look all right. Gets the fend off, but the final siren goes. And the St. Mary's rejuvenation continues. They've knocked off the reigning premier. 15-12, 102.
Somewhat convincingly.
St. Joey's 10-10, 70. And the champs are on the ropes, Milky.
They certainly are, mate. And really, when we go through our votes after this, you're going to find there will be very little mention of good players or of quality players from St. Joseph's.
Yep.
I just think a 32-point victory, 27 points up in the first quarter, that's where all the damage was done. And St. Joey sort of hung in there, but made no real inroads. They'll be having a look at this. I wonder how serious the injury to my old mate in Dale Carson is.
You'd like to think
it was just a head clash, so they just keep him off the ground. Well, we might. Where's the boss? We've got how many breaks we've got to have? One break. We might take that break. We'll come back with our better players, our final scores around the grounds.
I've got my grab.